Superblocks supports writing code to conditionally format data and components displayed on the front end using JavaScript. By taking advantage of double curly braces that we call bindings, you're able to write JavaScript expressions, enabling you to insert dynamic data and state anywhere in the application front end. Superblocks supports a number of JavaScript libraries, with a complete list being maintained in our documentation. This is my customer intake form. In this application, I'm collecting information from my customers to help filter them for our sales team. I'm asking each customer to provide me with a job title via a radio button. When a user selects the other field, I want to conditionally show an input field for collecting job title. First off, I'll add a new input box to my application that I'll call Other Input. After setting the label, I'll scroll down in the Properties panel to the Visible property. I'll change this to code and insert a binding so I can write a JavaScript expression. Visible takes a Boolean value, so I'll create a small if test to set the value to true when Other is selected. I'll do the same thing for the required field, so my validation will update based on user selection. I'll swap into preview mode to see how a user will experience these changes. When I click the Other option, my Other field will become visible, and the indicator that it's required will display. I'll head back into the application editor since I also want to capture today's date. I'll add a date picker and set the visibility to false and convert the default data to code. I'll add a binding using the Moment.js library to set the default value to right now. There are cases where you may want to write more complex JavaScript in the front end. For example, when using a state variable. Superblocks supports both temporary state variables for storing information in a user session that resets on a refresh, and local storage state variables to store information in the browser across a session. As both state variable types are stored on the client, they live in the front-end scope of an application and cannot be set from a back-end API. With front-end JavaScript, we're able to set, read, or update any state variable, regardless of the complexity of any business logic that might need to occur. In this task tracking application, we want to bubble up the recently visited tasks to the top so they're easily accessible when a user wants to revisit a recently visited task quickly. This application has a local storage state variable called recently viewed tasks that'll maintain state even when I close the application. To update my front-end state variable, I'll need to utilize some front-end JavaScript to track the 10 most recently viewed tasks. I'll create a run.js action to get triggered when a row is clicked. Since we're writing a longer JavaScript function, let's pop out the editor to make this easier to see. I'll copy-paste in my code, and now I'll use the Superblocks AI assistant to explain what it's doing. As our front-end JavaScript runs when I click a row, it'll update the recently viewed task. The table will update to display the recently accessed tasks first. I'll click multiple times to show how recently viewed tasks update when I click. By using JavaScript in the front end with Superblocks, you're able to make your internal tooling interactive, changing the properties of any component based on any condition.